Hi there, this is Ruben for Sonokinetic, and in this video I'm going to be taking a look at Sonokinetic's Alphorn. Alphorn runs in the full version of Kontakt, version 4.2.4 and above, and the library features almost half a gigabyte of samples recorded from a large wooden Alphorn in the south of Germany. So let's dig in. All the controls for Alphorn are on just this one interface here, and there's two variations of note range and tuning with this instrument, so let me cover those quickly. Most Kontakt users will be used to the blue keyboard here, which indicates the key range. But naturally, an Alphorn doesn't play every single note in the octave. It's mainly harmonics. So we've provided two versions of the instrument. This is the extended version where the samples have been hand-tuned to concert pitch and you can play every single note. But there's also an alternate version where the samples have been left as is, no tuning. And the only notes that are available are the ones that a real-life Alphorn can actually play. You can hear there the slight variations in tuning. So depending on your project, you might want to use either one of these versions. It's up to you. In terms of functionality, both these versions are almost exactly the same. However, there is one difference with the sustain articulation. We've captured legato transitions with the natural key range. So you can play monophonic legato here. With the extended range and tweaked tuning, there's no legato transitions, but you are able to play polyphonically. So I'll stick with extended for now, and let's look at the other controls. You heard there the sustains, there's also a staccato articulation, marcato, and sforzando. These articulations are all the same, natural or extended, and you can switch between them with the key switches from C5 to F5. We've also captured multiple velocities. And there are plenty of round robin samples. The order of these can be reset with the MIDI key switch at C6. So let's go back to the sustains. At the high velocities, you've got an option to add growl samples. This is controlled with the on and off growl switch here. And the velocity threshold at which these samples cut in is adjustable on this slider here. You can also use the MIDI key switch at A5, pressing either high velocity for on or low velocity for off. You can also control the overall volume level of the sustains with the mod wheel. The Alphorn has been sampled with two different microphone positions, both mono and stereo, and these are mixable with this dial just here. We've included a high, mid, and low EQ, so you can tweak the sound to taste. And you can control or command click any of these dials to reset them to their default positions. Lastly, there's a convolution impulse response, which we've included the controls for just here. You can adjust the level with this dial. And you can adjust the size of the room just here. For more options with the convolution reverb and the EQ, just head to the edit panel. You can swap out the impulse response for one of your own just here, or adjust some of the other aspects. You can also get more control over the EQ here. So that's the Alphorn from Sonokinetic. I hope you enjoyed the video. For more information, head to www.sonokinetic.net, and thanks so much for watching.